Hello, welcome to this continuous integration course with TeamCity. This course is focused for users of TeamCity, so it does not cover any of the administration related parts. Before we begin, let's define what continuous integration is. Back in May 2006, Martin Fowler defined continuous integration as a software development practice where members of a team integrate their work frequently, usually each person integrating at least once a day, which can lead often to multiple integrations per day. Now, each integration is verified by an automated build process, including tests, to detect integration errors as quickly as possible. So what exactly does this mean? Well, let's take a look at a typical scenario when we're building applications. Often, we're faced with a software system that's composed of different components. We have one person working on component one, and another person working on component two. Each of these people in isolation have the code and the unit tests, and everything normally works out great. They write their code, run their unit tests, and it's all fine. The same happens with the person working on component two. The problem is, however, that software systems aren't composed of individual and isolated components, but they are composed of components that normally have to work together. When we're doing teamwork, we often have source control, and we have different members of the team working and checking in their code to source control. And in principle, if everything is done correctly, all is good. The first person checks in the code, the second person checks out code, and everyone can continue to work in a normal way. However, reality tells us that things don't quite work as expected. Often, we end up where one developer checks in some code, and although the code that they were working on works perfectly, since components aren't normally meant to work with each other, the code that they check in can have side effects, causing other components to break and thus interrupting the workflow and the process of other people. As the other members of the team check out code, things can break. In a continuous integration scenario, what we can do is we have a thing called a CI server, which pulls source control. When the first developer checks in some code, the CI server gets notified that some code has been checked into source control and performs a series of automated builds and running of unit tests. It then delegates this process to some build agents, which can be either virtual or physical machines. And once these build agents complete the build process and run the unit tests, then they notify the developer indicating whether the code that they've just checked in has been successful or not. What this prevents is other people checking out code that potentially has broken the build. If something is broken, since all developers on a team are usually notified of the status of the build, they now know that they shouldn't be checking out the code until they get a successful build. Notification can occur using different mechanisms such as email, a tray icon, growl notifications, etc. Where does TeamCity enter the picture? TeamCity is this CI server that we've been talking about. It takes care of automating builds and deployment process. It increases the quality and the standards across teams by preventing broken builds being committed or notifying team members that there is a broken build. It acts also as an artifact and NuGet repository, which means that the result of a build can be available to other projects and to end users. And it also provides reporting and statistics on builds and the overall workflow of the team. And last but not least, it supports a variety of platforms and technologies. Here is a simple diagram showing all of the different technologies that are supported, from different browsers to different version control systems, development frameworks, both in Java, .NET, as well as Ruby and others, different build runners, different unit testing frameworks. It is quite heterogeneous in what it offers. TeamCity is a web application. As such, it runs via the browser. The browser is your user interface. It runs on Java. It's a server-side application running on Java. As such, it could be installed on a variety of platforms. And it integrates with many technologies and platforms. When you first access TeamCity, you're presented with a login page, and you can log in as a guest user, or you can log in as an authenticated user, where you get a different set of permissions based on how they've been assigned to you, allowing you to access different projects or different configuration items of the project. The main screen basically lists a series of configured projects, and we can access our changes, a list of all projects, agents, build queues, etc., all from here.